Welcome back. I'm glad to bring to you the second part of antenna array module. In the previous section, we discussed a specific condition of two isotropic point sources fed in equal amplitude and phase. We also realized that this is a necessary condition to achieve broadside radiation. In this section, we shall be discussing two more specific cases of excitations for radiating elements in any array. Firstly, we shall discuss a case of two isotropic point sources which are fed in equal amplitude but in opposite phase. Secondly, we shall discuss a similar case of two isotropic point sources fed in equal amplitude but in phase quadrature. The antenna array lecture series comprises of several derivations, and hence it is recommended that you work on them as you go through the video. So keep your pen and paper ready, and here we go. Moving on to our case 2, where we have an array of two isotropic point sources which are fed in the same amplitude but in opposite phase, unlike our case 1 that we have just discussed. The arrangement of the sources along the x-axis and all the relative terms remain the same as we have already discussed. So let's now look into the vector representation for currents in phase. This is our reference line. We shall now consider the vector, field vector from each of the sources. So from source 1 along path R1, I have E1 equal to E0 e raised to plus jk R1. This E1 makes an angle of psi by 2, where psi is the phase difference between the two sources. So here it is psi by 2 because this angle is made with respect to the origin. The reference is our origin and hence psi by 2. Now from source 2, I will have E2, which is given by E0 e raised to minus jk R2. This also makes an angle of psi by 2 with respect to the reference. This is the vector representation for currents in phase. What we want is a condition where the phase is of opposite direction. So I will consider the same setup as it is below, and I'm now going to introduce the opposite phase condition for source 2. Okay, so source 2 will now be of opposite phase, that is 180 degrees shift to this vector, and hence I have E2 equal to E0 e raised to minus j pi plus kr2. Pi is 180 degrees phase shift that we have introduced. So this is the vector representation for currents which are out of phase. Okay, so now let us move on to find the total electric field at this distant point P. The total field will be given by EP, which is E1 plus E2, and E1 is the field due to source 1, E2 is field due to source 2. We know this. E1 is given by E0 e raised to minus jk R1, E2 is given by E0 e raised to minus j pi plus kr2. We have just introduced 180 degrees phase shift at source 2, and hence this pi. Now I'll just separate this e raised to minus j pi outside, and so I have this term. I will also substitute the far field approximations in R1 and R2. We know what are the far field approximations. They remain the same as in case 1. So having done this, we will now rearrange the terms and will apply e raised to minus j pi equal to minus 1. This is what we understand from mathematics. So rearranging the terms, I get j2e0 e raised to minus jkr sine of kd by 2 sine cos phi, where kd cos of phi is psi. So j2e0 e raised to minus jkr sine of psi by 2 volts per meter is the net electric field at point P, which happens to be a distant point of observation. Now we'll take mod of EP. So mod of EP, I can get rid of e raised to minus jkr, and I have 2 e0 sine of psi by 2. Normalizing this, we have Ep normalized is equal to sine of psi by 2, which is also equal to sine of pi d cos of phi by 2. So now let us take an example and plot the radiation pattern for the same. In this example, I have two isotropic point sources which are fed in the same amplitude but opposite phase and are separated by a distance of lambda by 2. The objective of the example is to find the radiation pattern and also an expression for the electric field at a distant point P. So, if I know D, I can calculate psi, which is the phase difference between the two sources given by KD cos of phi. Substitute for D as lambda by 2 and you are left with pi cos of phi. Now, my expression for electric field, normalized electric field is sine of psi by 2. Substitute for psi, so you have pi by 2 cos of phi. This is the electric field at a distant point P. Of course, it's normalized. So now if I know this, I can find the value of the electric field at different phi. I can vary phi from 0 degrees to 360 degrees and compute the different values for the normalized electric field. So let's make a table of the same. So you have all of these listed in front of you. I will now use the polar plot to plot these values for different values of phi. These are the position of my isotropic point sources. I have a radiation pattern such as this. In this radiation pattern, the pattern is relatively broad, figure of 8, with maximum field in the same direction as the line joining the sources. That is, the maximum radiation is along the x-axis. The two sources in this case are described as simple type of end fire array and is in contrast to the pattern that we have observed for broadside array. In case of broadside array, the in-phase point sources produce a pattern with maximum field normal to the line containing the sources, or to be very specific, the plane containing the antenna sources. Whereas in case of end fire array, the maximum radiation or maximum field is in the plane containing the sources. Here I would also like to mention to you that never take lambda by 2 length of separation between two arrays for end fire radiation. This was just an example. It is always preferable that you take lambda by 4. We shall discuss this more in the subsequent series. In case 3, we have array of two isotropic point sources who are fed in the same amplitude, but the phase is in quadrature. So let's look at the arrangement first. You have the two point sources, source 1 and source 2, placed along the x-axis just as before. It's just that we have to note that if the origin is the reference, then source 1 is advanced by 45 degrees with respect to the origin and source 2 is 45 degrees retarded in comparison to the reference point at the origin. So now let us look at the vector representation. When the currents are in phase, then the vector representation is as shown here. Now let's look at the vector representation when they are in phase quadrature. So I have the reference which is at the origin. Now along this I will have the two fields E1 and E2. Now the dotted lines show us the representation when the vectors are in phase. Now I have to include a 45 degrees phase lag or lead for either of the sources. So that is pi by 4. Remember, psi by 2 is the phase difference with respect to the origin, even with respect to origin, and again psi by 2 is the phase difference of E2 with respect to the origin. Now let us introduce the 45 degree phase lead or lag. So source 1 is advanced. There's a lead of 45 degrees, that's pi by 4. So I have E naught e raised to minus jk r1 e raised to plus j pi by 4. In case of source 2, I'm adding another pi by 4. So to create a lag or retardation of 45 degrees, so source 2, the field due to source 2 is given by E naught e raised to minus jk r2 e raised to minus j pi by 4. So now let's move on to find the electric field at a distant point P and then further on to plot the radiation pattern. So to find the electric field at a distant point P, we will have EP is equal to E1 plus E2, where E1 is the field due to source 1 and E2 is the field due to source 2. Substitute for E1 and E2 by these terms that we have just arrived at. So E1 will be E0 e raised to minus jk r1 e raised to plus j pi by 4, and E2 will be E0 e raised to minus jk r2 into e raised to minus j pi by 4. So now we will substitute the far field approximations for R1 and R2, the phase terms. So you arrive at this form of the expression. You can take things common and rearrange the terms. So you have here e raised to plus j theta plus e raised to minus j theta. So applying your Euler's formula, you arrive at 2 cos of theta. So that's why you can get this expression as 2 e naught e raised to minus jkr cos of kd by 2 cos phi plus pi by 4. Now kd cos phi is psi. Okay, so let's before that take the magnitude. So magnitude of EP will be 2 e naught cos of kd cos of phi by 2 plus pi by 4. Further, we'll normalize it. So normalizing, you have EPN equal to cos of kd by 2 cos theta plus pi by 4. I can also call this as cos of psi by 2 plus pi by 4. So having formulated the expression for electric field at a distant point P due to two isotropic point sources which are fed in the same amplitude but in phase quadrature, we will now work on an example. And the distance of separation between the two isotropic sources, let it be lambda by 2. And having got this, we will find the expression for electric field and then plot the radiation plot. So psi, that is the phase difference between the two sources, is going to be pi cos of phi, because we have substituted d as lambda by 2. So the normalized electric field, which is given by cos of psi by 2 plus pi by 4, I'll substitute for the psi that we have just arrived at. So that makes it pi by 2 cos of phi. So I have the normalized electric field as cos of pi by 2 cos of phi plus pi by 4. So for all values of phi varying from 0 to 360, I can find different values for the normalized electric field. That means the corresponding electric field values. So let's tabulate this. So this is the tabulation, and let's plot this. The plot of this radiation pattern will be something like this. It's taken from Cross textbook, Antennas by Cross. So this particular radiation pattern shape is called as the cardioid shape radiation pattern. The cardioid shaped radiation pattern is a unidirectional pattern with maximum field in the negative x direction. You see that most of the radiation is in the second and the third quadrants. And the fields in the direction of phi equal to 0 degrees is same as the field in the phi equal to 180 degrees direction. The angle for maximum radiation is at 120 degrees and 240 degrees. These are our 5 max values. I would like you to look at another example wherein we consider the distance of separation to be lambda by 4. So in this case, psi will come to pi by 2 cos of phi, and subsequently I can arrive at a normalized electric field as cos of pi by 4 cos phi plus pi by 4. Now I would like you to plot the electric field due to various values of phi from 0 to 360 degrees. You can tabulate it and find the radiation pattern. So as an exercise, please go through this and do plot the radiation pattern. With this, we shall end part 2 of the series of lectures on antenna arrays. As promised, the learnings are kept short for maximum impact. In the next part of the series, we will discuss a few other excitation combinations and also n-element linear arrays. The reference material used in preparation of these lecture series are as cited above. I shall see you soon with part 3 of the antenna array series. Until then, take care and goodbye.